The sun just drops down. It's so beautiful. It reminds me summer is right around the corner. It is, by the way, not only the wedding season, as Debbie said, it's also the best time to sell your home. And here to show us how you can stage the rooms in your house, which is so important when you're selling a home, is Paige Hemmes. Hello,
yes,
Paige.
Thank you.
Can you just share, and only because Jesse was asking, what is staging?
Well, staging, that's a great question, Jesse. Staging is actually setting the stage for your home. So it is the art of prepping your house for sale to appeal to the most amount of buyers. You really want to kind of make it just smooth for everyone. You want the most people to come through your house and potentially buy. And studies have actually shown in the U.S., if you do stage your house properly, it's going to stay on the market about half the time as another house would that wasn't staged, and you get about 6 to 20% more of the purchase price just by staging it.
All right, so what are the important things to remember when you're staging your
home? Okay, first things first, for staging, the first thing you wanna do is depersonalize. And this is kind of the opposite of what we would do in our own home. This is kind of a mess, but people, they had a picture of mom and dad up above the fireplace and their little things.
Well, move your mattress from your living room? Is that what you're saying?
I don't judge.
All right.
Yes, but let's go to the after. We remove all of that and make it a very inviting place.
Wow.
So what I did here was, yes, and I had already taken down the picture of mom and dad, and it was a little creepy. That was a bank-owned property. But I put things that may appeal to everyone. So it's not a picture of me. It's not a picture of my loved ones. If I was staying there forever, of course it would be. But I picked things. This is at a cabin, so I brought things from the outside. I brought an old sleigh, you know, skis, things that don't really personalize it.
Say I was, say, close friends with Brad Pitt, and then I had a picture of Brad and I hanging out on the slopes. But I want to leave that up, maybe?
I don't know. You don't. Because what if that one person who is not a fan of the Brad Pitt walks through your house?
Yeah. Who is that? I actually haven't met them yet.
Yeah. But just in case, take the picture of you and Brad down. But let me just pick that up.
Pick the name off. Throw it over here. I'll catch it.
Yes. There you go.
Don't drop them. I paid a lot for that picture.
So depersonalize. That's number one. Number two, declutter. Now, you might not think it's very cluttered at your own house, but look around. This is
very cluttery.
This is my backside. This is it was cluttered because we were working at the time, but look around your house, and you guys at home, look around your house. Make sure the mail isn't sitting there. A bunch of magazines isn't sitting there. You might not even think it's cluttered, but here's the reason why you want to get rid of clutter. It creates anxiety. When a new person walks into your house, they don't feel very warm and happy. They're like, oh, they've got bills over there, and that's pretty messy. And for me, I had tools there. I had an old coffee cup and my vacuum out.
I don't even like looking at
it. No, it stresses you out, doesn't it?
Well, I want to clean it.
Subconsciously.
Seriously, put the stuff away. So then this is what we did for after. We simplified. We just put two chairs, an ottoman, a rug. Really, we just took everything out, and what would invite you? Come on in, have a sit down.
Right.
Yeah. Sit on one of these, enjoy. Yeah, and you can see that's just a mess. We went a bit further and framed those.
I was going to say that's
as
a
well.
Beautiful touch.
Yeah. But it was just a little. This, you know, it's kind of 90s. Look around your house. Yeah. If you have some of those things, there can be easy ways to fix it up.
Wow, what a difference!
Good at this.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, thank you. Yeah, I do this. Yes. But it was really sad, by the way, this morning, not having the DIY department. Song. Because I feel like this is DIY. Oh my gosh, thank you guys. Thank you. Yes.
I would have.
This is doing it yourself.
The wish is our command.
What about a feature piece now?
This is how I kind of design rooms. I take a feature piece. One of the biggest pieces in your home may be drapes. Drapes and furniture are probably your highest priced item. So what I did yesterday, I snuck in here while you guys were here. I cut a bit of this, the backside of this out. And then I took this to the store with me. First, I went to the hardware store. I tried to match colors. And I love bringing in, let's say I'm gonna match this blue. I love bringing in different shades of blue that won't clash. How do you know they won't clash? Find ones in the same color palette. These guys give you a cheat sheet.
Right.
So you can take this with you and then get all of your shopping done just based on these things. And that's what I did in here. All right.
Wow. Perfect. Final tips.
Well, let me show you what I did in here first. This is our before picture of this room. Let me tell you, this is our house. I actually love this room the way it is. And when you're staging a house, you're not making it better or worse. Well, hopefully you're not making it worse. But this is us. And like, we have friends who have written books that have left them for us. And this is what works for us. So, and it's absolutely gorgeous.
So sell me that room. What would it look like if you were going to stage this?
It would look like where you're sitting right now. So, yes. So what I did, I actually, if you look around, I took that feature piece, which was the blue in here, and I found ways to match it. And I'm actually going to start, well, actually, before I start behind you, I'm going to start right here. Now, staging is not always practical. You know, this is practical right down here. This is what this actually looks like every day when we film here. Do you see this? Mm-hmm. That's a bunch of books in there.
Well, thank goodness nobody sees it because it's a mess.
Right? And then this one, I just cleared the books out and put something. Is it practical? Probably not, but does
it
look
pretty.
Better?
It's very pretty.
It does. Yeah.
Very appealing to the eye.
Exactly. And you want to appeal to the most amount of people. This might stress somebody out.
Yeah, it does.
I have to, it's like homework. I've got to read.
Stresses me out every day.
Yeah. I'm going to hide it from you. But then I'm going to come around here. I'm going to start here on the floor. What I did was, and you can see our old carpet. This is a high traffic area. We've got a lot of friends.
Yes.
Jesse, want to let you know you're not the first that we've had here.
Yeah, to step on it.
So we do have a high traffic area, but taking this feature piece, this was $150 for this new rug, and it really makes the room feel amazing. Could also hide some imperfections underneath.
Very, yeah. You could also hide gum. I've got some gum over here.
You could hide whatever you want. And then behind you, I picked a depersonalized piece of artwork that it doesn't say it's my house. It doesn't say it could be anybody's house. You just pick those colors. Mm-hmm. Then come on over here. Now, the decluttering. Now, what we've done here is, and I think we have a before picture of what this looked like and how cluttered it was. There were a lot of books. There were a lot of really fun things, and that's the before picture. What we've done is just taken that back, stuck with the blues that were on my little cheat sheet, and if we did have some kind of crazy books, this is actually a DIY that Ken did, which I loved because it's neutral, and then we kept some of the books. We don't want to get rid of all of them, but it looks nice
and
clean.
And you kept the colors. I love the color, the consistency of the blues.
The blues are coming in, and it's a bunch of different blues.
Right.
Now, normally, you guys, when you host the show, we put these two chairs together.
Yeah. Well, we have to.
You do, right. Yeah. But when you're inviting somebody in, you want it to be open and inviting. Kind of angle them so that it allows for conversation. Because when you guys, you're typically interviewing us on that couch, but if you were to talk to one another, you'd have to do one of these.
We do.
So you angle it. Exactly.
What are you talking about?
What? That opens it up. Also, where I'm standing right here, there was another chair, two chairs, and a table in the middle. That is not inviting to come back here and have a sit down. We actually have a really nice area that you can come back, sit down, but when there's more furniture, it's kind of cluttered and it's kind of strange, you want to get rid of that so you can sit down, you know, maybe read a book, maybe, I don't know, show off something that you love. What is this, a do or a don't? It's a cat book.
It's a do.
It's a don't. I love kitties.
Oh, you love cats. I thought you meant for you. Yes, it's
but
a don't.
But for me it is. Yes, this would be at my house. This actually is at my house. This one of my kitties is in here. But when you're depersonalizing, you're taking away your loves, taking away my little kittens, because I want to appeal to the most amount of buyers.
And I'm going
to
make how much extra money by doing this?
Up to 20% more. That could be a lot.
Let's see the before and after of the rooms, maybe.
The before and after. Keep in mind that I love our before.
It's beautiful. I love
it. But if you're selling to the most amount of people,
it's
you want
very appealing.
It
a pop of colors, everything.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. Nice job.